We find that companies are coming to us and asking for certain design aspects, and they're really driven from two aspects. One, companies are really trying to drive innovation, and secondly, coming off a global economic downturn, they see that their employees really need to have a sense of security and focus on them. So out of that, the requests that we're hearing are driving four major design trends. The first is focusing on community. And community has two levels. First, it is bringing people together. And in order to get innovation, you need collaboration. And so when we bring people together is how we come to innovation ideas. But the second aspect of community that's really important is giving people what they need. And so if you think about the idea of a city, you start with a town square, and then you go to a neighborhood, you drill down to a house, and then to an individual room in the house. And that's how people want to think about their office space. Give people places to get together, but also to be alone. So the second idea is well-being, and it used to be a focus on your physical health in the office space, but we're finding now that it's really about mind, body, and soul, and we like to think about it in terms of Maslow's hierarchy of needs. So companies are really focusing on providing ideas of the base of the triangle, if you think security, functional needs like air and water, but in an office it might be more like private space or technology, things that help them get their work done. And eventually, if you give the employees all these really basic needs, it will allow them to get to a place of self-actualization or innovative and creative thinking. Hospitality is a very huge request, and you know, we're calling it the Starbucksing of America. Every company wants a coffee bar, and it really is creating a sense of welcome and comfort for employees. Give them a place where they can just be quiet and relax. So we have these spaces in a large kind of call center, if you will, and usually they need to be a quick in and out kind of break space. But this client really wanted to give their employees a place where they could really detach from the hard calls they may take and really get lost, and that's it's a really different way of thinking about a call center. So we're designing very large break rooms, which would seem frivolous in the past, but what's happening is companies are using those rooms as large meeting spaces too. So they're finding they can invest in these really great spaces for people to sit and have coffee, and when they're not having coffee, they can do training. And finally, flexibility is important to almost every corporate client that we talk to. And because space is at such a premium, they need to be able to multipurpose or use their space in any way they can on the fly. And that's the first level. Can an employee work here at their desk one day? Can they go in a room in the next hour? And can they go on another floor and work in the third hour? The second and third levels of flexibility really involve, can they multi-purpose a room? Can they use a space for many different functions? And then finally, can a company take an entire footprint of their office, say 20, 40,000 square feet, and really change the way it flows and the types of rooms fairly easily without having to take out a huge construction contract? Okay, so our design work for technology companies has really taught us a lot about flexibility and how they can reconfigure their space quickly. So the workstations are highly movable. We have power coming out of the ceiling in a way that they can move that furniture around and not worry about having to connect to the power. Well, it's an exciting time right now because a lot of these trends are being driven by millennial or creative companies, but it's really resonating with almost every company that we talk to, even law firms or accounting firms, and every generation that's in the workplace.